Good Lord. This ProJared situation with Heidi just got a lot more complicated, but please, please, for the love of God, stay until the end of this video because there is a very important message for all of you out there. What is up, everybody? This is Chris from The Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And if you're new to my channel, what I like to do is take a look at the YouTube community or pop culture and try to take this mess and turn it into a message to see what kind of lessons we can learn. Because what good is consuming all of this craziness if we're not trying to see how we can apply it to our own lives? So if you're into that stuff, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. So in this video, we're gonna be talking about things like open relationships and polyamory and things like that. But before I get started, no matter what I say my views or opinions are on the subject of this, ProJared is not out of the woods yet, okay? ProJared made a statement, and I'll read that in a second for all of you, but there are still some very serious allegations against ProJared, like sending unsolicited crotch pics. Not cool. Nobody really is down for those, all right? But there's also allegations that he was messaging people in a sexual manner who were underage, okay? So just so you know, those are still allegations. Don't know what's gonna come of those, but I am focusing on the topic of polyamory for the purpose of this video. All right? Okay. So anyways, ProJared came out yesterday with a statement about the situation with Heidi, all right? I am deeply sorry to anyone who has seen the accusations, vitriol, or unwanted photos that my former partner Heidi and others have been posting online since last Wednesday, May 8th, 2019. The truth is that Heidi and my marriage has been in a bad place for some time. I never wanted any of those details to become public for both Heidi and my mental well-being, but they have, and the accusations being made now must be addressed. A few years ago, Heidi asked me if we could be in an open, polyamorous marriage. I recognize now that this request and my willingness to go along with it was an unhealthy attempt to solve deeper issues that had developed within our marriage. Heidi has taken several casual partners and has been in a more serious relationship with another partner since 2017. Whether done to make her own actions just feel justified or because she genuinely believed it would help me build self-esteem, Heidi suggested that I also engage with other women. Heidi encouraged me to tell Holly that I was developing feelings for her, but when I did, things changed with Heidi. She became angry and vindictive and did not want me to see or speak with Holly anymore. She called me a cheater and claimed that I was destroying our marriage because of my affair, even though she continued to have other relationships with other partners. I never wanted to destroy our marriage, and I spent months after that doing what I could to repair it through couples therapy and extensive individual therapy. Those close to me have witnessed Heidi's behavior towards me on many occasions and have begged me to leave for some time. I was many things during this time, including embarrassed, scared, and broken, but I was never the abuser. I made several attempts to leave, starting in October 2018, but each time she refused to let it happen, threatening to destroy my career and to harm others if I left. Despite all this, I tried to end things amicably. I helped Heidi find a new place to live and paid the initial deposits. I bought her a car to facilitate her independence. I formally filed for divorce on May 13th, 2019, and I've instructed my attorneys to make sure she receives her fair share of what I earned while we were together. I genuinely never wanted any of this to happen, but I finally realized that I have no other choice. Even though I have been tempted to put information out online that shows my side of the story, I don't want to further stoke the fires of what should be a private matter between us. My hope is that both of us continue to pursue therapy and come out of this unfortunate situation better people. But I want everyone to know that any other interactions I have had with any other women were known to and encouraged by Heidi and were had with only the purest and lawful intentions. I am sorry to everyone that I disappointed. I realize that as a public figure, I am held to a higher standard. I have made my share of mistakes, but I have only ever tried to do what's best for Heidi and me. All right, so couple things real quick. Y'all wanna be famous, y'all wanna be celebrities, y'all wanna be these big bad YouTubers. Like, this is nuts. This is nuts because people have to come out and share the most intimate details of their relationship. Like, if you're just like a normal person, you gotta kinda like tell your friends and family, like, yo, this is what happened, and like, it happens in your friend group. But this is happening in front of thousands, if not millions of people, all of this, all right? So check yourself when you're like, oh, I wanna be a famous YouTuber. You get all this money and everything's fine. No, 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 no. Like, there's stuff that comes along with it. So when this statement first came out, I DM'd one of my buddies in the YouTube community who has been following this story. I'm like, yo, what do you think about ProJared's statement? Like, do you really think that it was like polyamory and then Heidi turned it into cheating or whatever? And he's like, I don't know, man. He's like, I'm really like leery of stuff. And like, when somebody says that there's more to this story, but they don't post receipts, I'm like, true that, man. I hear that. But right after, Heidi took to Twitter and she said this: polyamory requires transparency and consent. Otherwise, it's just good old fashioned cheating. People keep asking for clarification. We attempted polyamory and then I shut it down in no uncertain terms. I never had anything to hide from him, period. I did not receive the same transparency. Okay, okay, everybody. This is for you and everybody you know. Listen, okay. Can polyamorous relationships work? Yes, absolutely. They can work. If you want to be in an open relationship, if you want to be in a polyamorous relationship, you do you, baby girl. But like, I have seen this happen so many times, it makes my brain want to explode, all right? Like, it is tricky. It is difficult, okay? And like ProJared said, what it seems like is that they were trying to share or save the relationship by attempting to do polyamory, sleep with other people, all right? And like, it's tricky, it's difficult. Like, when you marry somebody, when you marry a person, you are committing to them in a monogamous relationship. You are saying, hey, you are the only person for me, you are the only person I want. It is just me and you, baby, me and you, right? And then things start to go downhill and they try to save the relationship with polyamory. Feelings get hurt. It's what happens. It is human nature for feelings to get hurt in that way when you have committed to somebody like that, all right? And what we're all seeing, and this is what I keep trying to tell all of you guys, like, everything's not so black and white. Like, things are messy, and it's just, it sucks for these people in the public spotlight where, like, it's all just put out there. Like, it's all put out there. Relationships can get messy and tricky and difficult and crappy, like, but now it's just out there? You know what I mean? And, like, the problem is that the rules change. The rules kind of like what Heidi was saying was, she changed her mind on it. Like, what? What? Like, it was like halfway out there. And again, like, there's still some very serious allegations against ProJared, and I don't know what's gonna come of those. But in this situation, like I kind of said about James Charles with Gage, or James Charles with that kid, the waiter from Seattle, like, those were just messy situations. It seems like consensual situations that turned into a mess, and now they're just out there in the public for all of us to see. Now, what I'll say about polyamory, like, I remember listening to a podcast a long time ago, and in some parts of the world, like, monogamy is not how we're, like, the people are trained to be. So, like, being non-monogamous, being with multiple partners, that is the norm. But, like, in our Western culture, we're kind of raised in that way. And there's nothing wrong with that. Like, I got my beautiful girlfriend, Tristan. That's all I want. That's all I need, right? But, like, I think, like, especially, this is something that I've seen come up more and more in recent years, but like, I'm telling you right now, like, I have so many friends, like, I'm not just talking out of my ass here. I've had so many friends who are just like, I'm gonna be polyamorous, and the next thing you know, they're on Facebook talking about how they got their heart broken because they develop feelings. You know what I mean? Like, just quit BSing yourself. Like, just quit BSing yourself. Like, when I look at this situation, like, don't BS yourself. Like, oh, I love you, I just wanna sleep with other people. Like the feelings aren't there anymore. Just end the relationship. Like, don't just lie to yourself and just say, oh, well, everything would be fine if we could just sleep with other people. No, because now this is blown up into this explosive hot mess. Just separate from each other, you know? Like, that's the issue. That's such a problem, especially just like with relationships is people hold on to them for so many reasons. I've had people hold on to relationships like for kids, right? For children. You know, that's kind of how my relationship was with my son's mother, and we ended up splitting up and we're like best friends today, but like, is that fair to anybody involved, me, her, or the child, if we're just staying together just for the kid? I've seen people stay in relationships for family members, right? Like the family likes her or the family likes him, right? So they stay in the relationship for them. You know what I mean? Like, who are we staying in this relationship for? Like, this is between you and the other person. Like, I know breakups suck, but stuff like this just makes the whole situation a lot messier because you are prolonging the pain, all right? So again, I am not against polyamory in any way, shape, or form, but from my experience, in most cases, they turn into absolute messes because people start developing feelings, all right? So what ProJared was saying was, he was encouraged to start seeing Holly. He was encouraged to start seeing her, but then Heidi got jealous. You know what I mean? And whether or not that's true, we'll never know. But there's two sides to this story. Truthfully, like, I'm done covering this story because, like, when I see it, I'm like, man, it is just a mess. But, like, if the allegations come out that, you know, ProJared was taking advantage of his position of power with, you know, younger people who are fans of his, that is a whole different ballgame, and we'll have to talk about that at another time. But anyways, let me know. Let me know down in the comments below. Have you tried to be in an open relationship or a polyamorous relationship, and it's turned into a hot mess? If it's worked out, maybe you could share some tips and advice down below and let us know how the hell you made that happen, all right? But anyways, that's all I got for this video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell because I make a ton of videos. And a huge, huge thank you to everybody supporting the channel over on Patreon. You're all amazing. And if you would like to become a patron, get your name up in the credits, get involved in our monthly Q&A, get some free books and some other cool stuff, click or tap right there, all right? Thanks again so, so much for watching. I'll see you next time.